be gracious and begin to walk humbly before my God. And every time that birthday come around, each and every one of us, we get a birthday every single year. And I'm thankful for it. In 2 weeks, I'll be 34 years old. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I never thought I would see 30 years old. When I was growing up, I was in so much drama. I was in so much crime. I never thought that I would see 30 years old. But I want you to know that God had a plan for my life. Yes. That God had a purpose for my life. Yes. I want you to know that I had my own plans established. I had goals that I wanted to meet. There are things that I wanted to accomplish in life. But I want you to know something, that God, He had a different plan. He had a different plan, folks. And it's only because His loving kindness and His mercy. Sometimes I even thank God for the pain that I go through, because it reminds me how close we are getting to eternity. Every single day we're getting closer and closer and closer to eternity. See, the problem that folks have in the world today is that, we are saved by God's grace. Oh, we're going to wait on God's grace. God knows my heart. Oh, but one thing, God's grace may not run out, but I'll tell you one thing that do run out. Time.
Amen.
Time runs out, folks. You have a biological clock, okay, that is ticking. And every day that you wake up, you're getting closer and closer to eternity. The Bible says that it is appointed for man to die one time. That's all it takes, folks. It's one time. Then come judgment. Judgment is coming, folks, whether you like it or not. The Bible says, "For I reckon that the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us." Paul said he is thankful that we have been delivered, folks, from the kingdom of Satan. We have been delivered from the kingdom of darkness and been translated us into the kingdom of His dear Son, Jesus. Let me tell you something, folks, that speaks volume. Because you were dead in your trespasses. You were dead in your sin. And you were on your way to hell. Without God in this world. Alienated from the covenant. Separated from God. Because the Bible says that sin separates us from God. And there are many of you that are sitting out here today and that are listening from the sound of my voice that are battling with sin. You are a slave to sin. But Jesus, He has reconciled us, folks. He has brought us back. There was a separation between God and man in the beginning. Jesus is that mediator between heaven and earth. There's no other way to get to God. There's no other way to go to heaven but through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I want you to know it's a free gift tonight. Only if you're willing to accept it. Hallelujah. Oh, glory, glory, glory. The interesting thing He said was translated. He said you were translated. That means to turn from another one language or a foreign language unto his own. Paul said in verse 21, and you have that was sometime alienated, an enemy of the mind by wicked works, yet now has been reconciled. We couldn't even speak the same language as God, folks. We wasn't even on the same page as God. We wasn't even in communication with God. But here the scripture says that we were alienated. We were separated because of the war that is going on in our mind. What is going on in your mind that is separating you from God? Is it drugs? Is it alcohol? Is it lust? Is it addiction? Come on, folks. There's a battle going on. And the war is in the mind. And the only way that you're going to be able to stay alive is through the Word of God.
Amen.
Through the Word. That's the only way you're going to be able to stay alive. In Proverbs, the Bible says, Proverbs 15:29, the Lord is far from the wicked, but he hears the prayers of the righteous. Only one thing that God hears from a soul that is lost, for a soul that don't know Jesus, only thing God hears is the sound of repentance. That's the only thing that Jesus hears from a sinner, is the sound of repentance. Lord Jesus, forgive me. I know that I am a sinner. I know that I have messed up. I know that I'm not in right standings with you. That's the only thing that Jesus hears. He don't hear prayers of any sinners. The Bible says that he is far from the sinners, but he is close to those that walk in righteousness. He is close to those that walk in truth. Hallelujah, somebody. And you wonder why you're not being blessed. You wonder why that your health is failing. You wonder why you can't find no job. You wonder why you don't have any shelter over your head. Because the Bible says that God is far from the wicked. He's far. This is why the wicked die early. This is why the wicked die sudden. This is why the wicked has no warning, the Bible says. No warning.
Wow, that's powerful.
And some of you today that are listening, that are sitting here, you're alienated. You're separated from God. You're the enemy of your own works by your own mind. The battle of the mind, that's when it starts, folks. Hallelujah. What are you craving tonight? What is it lust that's in your mind? Is it drug addiction? Is it alcohol addiction? Is it porn? Is it violence? These are the works of the wicked. Hallelujah. A lost soul, folks, can be reconciled tonight. A lost soul can come in communion. A lost soul can come into relationship tonight. Because Jesus, he has paid the way for you. Reconcile. Reconcile means to reestablish a close relationship. To reestablish that relationship that God intended for mankind to have with him. That's what reconcile means. In verse 20 of Colossians says this, and having made peace, here you go. You ready for it? Having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him that reconciled all things unto himself. And by him I say, whether that be things that are on earth or that in heaven, through his cross, folks, not yours, not your own mind. But his cross, Jesus told us to take up our cross and to follow him. There's only one cross that can establish forgiveness of sin, reconcile and be mended with a relationship with mankind. Only the cross of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. More than enough to pay the price of redemption and to rescue you from Satan's kingdom of darkness.
Amen.
The Bible says that Satan is the god of this world, folks. You see why there's so much violence. You see why there's so much hate. You see why there is so much ungodliness. Because the Bible says that Satan is the god of this world. Not the earth, God bless you, but the world, meaning people. The world. He has blinded their eyes. A blindness, there's a shield that's been put on your eyes. When you live in sin, when you're operating in darkness, there's a shield. The devil is trying to blind you from the truth of God's word, from being set free. The devil's trying to blind you that there's a healer that exists. He's trying to blind you that there's a deliverer that exists. He's trying to blind you. He's trying to confuse you. He's trying to hit you with deception that if you die in your sins, that there ain't no hell and there ain't no heaven to hold you. But the devil is a liar, folks. I came here to tell you today that if you die without Christ, you are doomed.
Amen.
You are.
I brought about 4 or 5 people.
You will perish. Jesus says, unless you repent, you will perish. flesh. Repent me, turn around. Turn from your wicked ways. Come to God, ask Him to forgive you. Tell Him that you're sorry. Tell Him that you want to be in His family. Through the cross. It's only through the cross. There is power in the cross. It's undeniable, folks. The Bible said that it's the power of salvation unto them that believe it. I am a living witness of that power.
Thank you, guys.
I should have been dead and gone a long time ago.
Yep.
I should have been dead and gone 5 years ago when that man came into the store when I was working at Metro PCS and he pointed a 38 right at my forehead.
Wow.
A 38. He pointed it right at me. But I didn't take him serious. I laughed at him. I chuckled. I didn't take him serious.
Woo.
He said, give me all the money. One thing I'm not about to die over is nobody else's money.
Amen, Pastor.
I wasn't going to die anyway because it wasn't my time.
Woo! Yes, Lord.
Let me tell you something. No barber, no Roman soldier, nobody back in Jesus' time put him to the cross. The Bible says that God has given Jesus the power to lay his life down and to raise it back up again. And that's what he did for you and I. The Bible says that the gates of hell should not prevail against the church. We are the true church of Jesus Christ. If you accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the gates of hell cannot prevail against you.
Yes.
Do you believe that though?
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That's the question.
Hallelujah.
Because lately a lot of Christians have not been walking in faith. They've been walking in unbelief, especially when Corona hit. The churches stop coming out. The churches stop witnessing. I thought we had the power of God unto salvation to him that believe it. Or is it all talk? Let me tell you something. The kingdom of God is not a matter of talking. It's with power. It's with demonstration.
Yes.
How would the people know if they ain't got no preacher? The preacher must go out. He must preach the word of God so that the people could come in. We ain't got time to be warming no bitches while people are dying and going to hell. Think about how many souls that have been taken to hell because of Corona. Think about it. It comes to steal the breath of life from you. Corona is an attack from the enemy. Because Jesus, God the Father, he has breathed the breath of life in you. Right now, the only reason why you're alive and sustaining is because of the breath of God.
That's right.
But we got a real enemy, folks. The devil, Satan, he comes to take that breath from you. That same life that Jesus said, I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly, have it more freely. The devil, he comes to take that from you. Hallelujah. The Bible said as soon as the word of God is preached, the enemy comes immediately. See, right now I'm planting seeds, and some of the seeds I'm watering, but I know God, he's going to come. He's going to be the one that's going to give the increase. But I want you to know something, that the devil, he comes to steal this word. He's coming, folks. I'm not about to sit here and sugarcoat him and sit here and lie to you, act like the devil ain't real. Let me tell you something. Living for Jesus is not for suckers.
Amen.
It's not for punks. Because we are in a fight. We are in a war, folks. And the sooner that you can understand that, the sooner that you can get that, the sooner you can come along and be a part of God's laborers, that we can labor in the vineyard. The Bible says that the laborers are few, but the harvest is ready. You see, the God is ready, people are ready, but where are the laborers? Where they at? You are laborers. You are ambassadors of Christ, those that are sitting over here. You're laborers. It's time to step up. It's time to rise up. God has given you something special. Don't let it go to waste. What are we waiting for? We are the body of Christ. It's time to rise up.
Amen.
It's time to rise up. God, who is all knowing, God doesn't need us to confess our sins to him. We need to confess our sins. We need to. Literally means to say that I am in agreement with you, Father, so that we can see what we have done or have failed at in God's perspective. I truly believe that if most of us understand how much our sinful rebelliousness hurts the Holy Ghost, hurts God, we wouldn't do it. We wouldn't do it. If God didn't have his grace that he has now, we wouldn't sin, because God, he didn't tolerate sin in the Old Testament. He didn't tolerate it.